Before the citizenship ceremony, 55 people represented 24 different countries. They all took the oath of allegiance in a conference room overlooking the Big Sioux River in downtown Sioux Falls. COVID restrictions meant family members had to watch from outside. They peered in through a window, even as temperatures reached 100 degrees. Jeffrey Beal is a supervisory immigration services officer. He says they had to split up families during the ceremony to keep people safe.
Part of our safety protocols, we try to maintain social distancing and just following CDC guidelines. So in order to maintain that social distancing, it limits the capacity of any space that we occupy, whether it's for a naturalization ceremony or at our field office.
Outdoor naturalization ceremonies can handle a bigger audience, like the event at Mount Rushmore earlier this summer. There, another 55 people became newly minted United States citizens. Yvonne Martin had hoped to be in that crowd at Mount Rushmore, but a federal agency decides which event you attend. She now lives in Rapid City after immigrating from the United Kingdom. Instead, she drove across the state to Sioux Falls for her ceremony. Family members couldn't attend, and her husband waited in the car. Despite the limited audience, Martin says she felt a deep sense of pride as she stood and raised her right hand.
When I was making the oath of allegiance, you're thinking about your original country and about your new country and about how it would make you really proud to be asked to do any of these things, such as, you know, represent your country. I think that would be really exciting. They probably won't ask a 61-year-old to do very much, but I'm sure I would make quite a good American spy.
The oath includes renouncing foreign allegiances, defending the U.S. Constitution, and taking up arms on behalf of the United States when required. But Martin is most excited about another civic duty.
Being able to vote is probably the most important thing, being able to kind of take a full part rather than just discussing.
She also hopes to expand her consulting business to work with the military, which her citizenship now makes possible. And in keeping with South Dakota's agricultural leaning, there's another element to Martin's entrepreneurial spirit.
So I've started making, very successfully, started making my own hot sauce, which is called Piping Hot. Piping being the Scottish piper that has a little bagpiper on the logo. I have a whole garden full of chili plants on the go at the moment, and hopefully in the harvest this year then I'll be able to make quite a big sampling batch for. You never know what might happen. So, but they say America is a land of opportunity, so here we go.
After the ceremony in Sioux Falls was over, Yvonne Martin was one of 55 people, all representing the same country.